Hi students, today we will learn about the classification of cholinergic and anticholinergic drugs. Cholinergic agonists, they basically classified into two groups. They are choline esters and choline alkaloids. In the choline esters group, we have acetylcholine, methacholine, carbachol, methanecol. In the choline alkaloid group, we have muscarine, pilocarpine, arecoline. Next group of drugs are anticholinesterases. These are the drugs which inhibit the enzyme acetylcholinesterase at the synaptic cleft, thereby increases the concentration of choline, especially in the neuromuscular junction. So they also have the action similar to that of cholinergic agonists. So they are called anticholinesterases. And we can classify these anticholinesterases into two types. That is, the drugs which reversibly inhibit the cholinesterase enzyme, they are called reversible anticholinesterases, and the drugs which irreversibly inhibit the enzyme acetylcholinesterase, they are called irreversible anticholinesterases. So in the reversible anticholinesterases, we have two categories of drugs. They are carbamates and acridine. In the acridine group, we have tacrine. In the carbamate group, we have physostigmine, neostigmine, pyridostigmine, endrophonium, rivastigmine, donepezil, and galantamine. In the irreversible anticholinesterase group, there are two types. They are organophosphates and carbamates. In the organophosphate group, diflos, icothiophate, malathion, diazinon, tabun, sarin, somal. These are the organophosphate compounds and these are the irreversible anticholinesterases. And in the carbamate group, we have carbaryl and propoxor. This carbaryl, propoxor, malathion, diazinon basically used as insecticides. And this tabun, sarin, somal, they are the nerve gases which are used in chemical warfare. We'll move on to the classification of anticholinergic drugs. They act as an antagonist at the cholinergic receptors, basically muscarinic receptors. So we can classify anticholinergic drugs into three types. They are natural alkaloids, semi-synthetic derivatives, and synthetic compounds. In the natural alkaloid group, we have atropine, hyoscine. And in a semi-synthetic group, we have homotropine, atropine methonitrate, hyoscine butyl bromide, iptratropium bromide, tiotropium bromide. In the synthetic compound group, they are further classified as midriatics, anti-secretory antispasmodics, vesicoselective drugs, and anti-Parkinsonian drugs. In the midriatic group, there are two drugs. They are cyclopentolate and tropicamide. In the anti-secretory antispasmodic group, we have two categories of drugs. They are called quaternary compounds and tertiary amines. No problem, we can just write the drugs names also. In the quaternary compounds, we have propanthiolin, oxyphenonium, clidinium, pipenzolate, methyl bromide, isopropamide, and glycopyrrolate. The glycopyrrolate is most often used drug, so it's very important in this group. And oxyphenonium, clidinium also used less often. Other drugs, I feel they are not that much clinical importance. So, but we should definitely have to remember and you should learn everything about glycopyrrolate. Okay, in tertiary amine, dicyclomine, valathamate, and pyrenzepine. In the vesicoselective group, we have oxybutynin, flavoxate, tolterodine. In the anti-Parkinsonian group, we have trioxyphenidyl, benzoxol, procyclidine, and bipyridine. These are the anticholinergic drugs. Okay. We'll learn about the ganglionic stimulants. Ganglionic stimulants are classified as selective nicotinic agonist and non-selective muscarinic agonist. In the selective nicotinic agonist group, there are drugs like nicotine, lobelin, piperazinium, and tetramethylammonium, that is TMA, and varenicline. In the non-selective muscarinic agonist, we have acetylcholine, carbachol, pilocarpine, and anticholinesterases. These are basically the cholinergic drugs, and which act at the muscarinic receptors. Coming to the ganglionic blocking agents, which can be classified as competitive blockers and persistent depolarizing blockers. In the competitive blocker group, there are three types. They are quaternary ammonium compounds, amines, either the secondary amines or the tertiary amines, and monosulfonium compound. In the quaternary ammonium compound group, there are two drugs. They are hexamethonium and pentolinium. In the amine group, we have mechalamine, pempidine. In monosulfonium compound group, there is trimethaphan and camphor sulfonate. In the persistent depolarizing blocker group, there are two drugs which act as a persistent depolarizing blockers at larger doses. They are nicotine and anticholinesterases. Okay, this completes the ganglionic blocking agents. The anticholinergic drugs as well as anticholinesterases classification is very important. Less often they may ask the cholinergic drugs and ganglionic blocking agents as stimulants, but the most important is the anticholinergic drugs as well as anticholinesterases. Don't get confused with the anticholinesterases and anticholinergic drugs. The anticholinesterases have the similar action like that of cholinergic agonist, but anticholinergic, they are antagonist at the muscarinic receptors. They have an action opposite to that of acetylcholine. They prevent the action of acetylcholine. Okay, this completes the classification of cholinergic drugs, anticholinergic drugs, as well as ganglionic stimulants and ganglionic blocking agents. Thank you.